On January 15th, 1967, the University of Arizona Symphonic Marching Band was invited to participate in the halftime activities of the world's first Super Bowl. The band took the audience, the Coliseum, and the viewers of two television networks on a musical visit to the four corners of the United States. Under the direction of Jack Lee and Richard Peters, the band started their program with a musical introduction from Richard Rodgers, The Sound of Music. By world champion baton twirler Richard Smith, the band went on to present The Sounds of Dixie with Waiting for the Robert E. Lee. To help create the sounds of the South, Mr. Al Hurt, world-famous trumpeter from New Orleans, joined the band for some trumpet solos. First on the list was Way Down Yonder and New Orleans. The band's trumpets moved to the forefront and joined Al Hurt for a Bugler's Holiday. Moving to the west, a band brought the super sounds of Law and Justice to the show. While playing a melody written to express one of a Western cowboy's deepest feelings, "Don't Fence Me In," they formed a well-known old Western fence. This fence has been synonymous with law and order in the Old West for many years, the OK Corral. Within the confines of the OK Corral, the famous lawmen Wyatt Earp and Doc Holliday engage in mortal combat with the dangerous outlaws, the Clanton brothers. However, before the deadly battle began, the University of Arizona Twirling Circus, under the guidance of their director, Mrs. Shirley Bertolini, displayed their talents to the strains of "Bury Me Not on the Lone Prairie." Having finished up the problems of the outlaws in the days of the Old West and a few of the innocent bystanders, the band went on to perform the super sounds of industry from the north and created a huge machine on the field. Moving from the sounds of the north to the sounds of the east, the band stepped to the music of "The Liberty Bell March" by John Philip Sousa. On the field, a Liberty Bell was formed, which rang, and of course, cracked. Having paid tribute to the four corners of the United States, the band proceeded to honor the professional football leagues, which had come together to compete in the world's first Super Bowl. To symbolize the meeting of the leagues, two giant football players were formed on the field. In keeping with the spirit of the merger of the nation's professional football leagues, the music played was "Marching Along Together." As the time drew near to kickoff, the figures moved toward each other and toward two large footballs on the field. Thank you. of Arizona Symphonic Marching Band is then joined by the Grambling College Marching Band from Grambling, Louisiana. Together, the bands formed a map of the United States. When this map was plated, flags representing each of the teams of both the National and the American Football League were marched into position. The teams were introduced individually to the fans, and the flags located in their respective cities on the map. For the finale, the two bands, along with the University of Southern California chorus, combined to perform "This Is My Country."